Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Ten Pin Bowling Show's presentation of the 2008 Ten Pin Shootout. Joining me in commentary today is Zach Rebix. And Zach, this is an interesting format now. The eliminations are over and done with. It's two tie, all tie.
That's right, Brenton. It should be interesting to see how the bowlers can cope with the pressure.
Let's go down to the action. And leading off the action is Gordon Colmer, 37 years old from Adelaide.
Next is Isaac Elliott from Woodfield Bowl.
In the third position for this first frame is Ashley Warren.
And finally, the only female in the event, Danielle Elliott.
Gordon Colmer leading off the action here. Important to get off to a good start. Try and put some pressure on your opposition. Being in the lead-off position, it's an ideal spot to be in.
Just a bit high on that shot, but I'm sure he'll make the spare.
A little bit high. Looked like it's just a little bit tense on that shot.
Certainly when you're playing for big money.
See, the ball goes through the nose there. Kicks out the 10-pin. That's important because he has to go back, make the spare. It is possible that Nate Spare could win. Could win a skin.
Quite possibly. And does. Beautiful spare.
Yep. Hard and straight at the 4-7 there. Next up is Isaac Elliott.
He had a string of strikes going in the qualifying. Let's see if he can keep them going.
High game of 300, which he shot recently. He's been in some pretty reasonable form. This is his home centre. Should know the lanes pretty well. Let's see how he goes.
Nice and smooth at the foul line and gets the result.
Yeah, good solid pocket shot there. Isaac unusually is not playing a lot of hook. He normally likes to stand a bit further left, swing the ball out towards the gutter. He's playing a fairly straight angle. The ball he's using doesn't hook a great deal.
But it gets the result.
Absolutely. Sometimes straighter is greater, especially under pressure. Yeah. Ashley Warren now, he's been in some pretty hot form lately.
He has. Recently throwing a second 300.
That's right, and he's had some good results of late.
Let's see if he can get a strike to make two tie, all tie.
Plenty of reds on that one.
Bang, and smashes the pins.
That's a great shot. And now we have the two tie, all tie situation, so
right.
We have a jackpot of the first skin.
It doesn't really matter what Danielle does now, just make a good shot in the next frame.
She'll be out to just make sure that she throws a good shot, gets herself lined up.
Gets rid of some of those early nerves.
That's right. It's actually probably a good position for her because it's already the two tie, all tie. She can just go out there, execute a shot.
And try a different line, even if she wanted to. And a 10-pin there.
Hit the pocket. Ball went a little bit long. Probably playing a little bit too tight of a line there. And the 6-pin just laying against the 10-pin. Again, she'll go back, try and make the spare. And it's important that she get herself lined up with the spares because, as we've said before, it is entirely possible a spare could win a skin.
That's right.
You can visit us at our website, thetenpinbowlingshow.com.au.
And it's got a forum, which is great to keep in touch with bowling.
We have a two tie, all tie situation. We've had a pair of strikes, so the skin for the second frame will jackpot. Isaac Elliott will lead off, Ashley Warren will be second, Danny Elliott will be third, and Gordon Colmer, original lead off, will take up the anchor position. Let's go to the second frame.
Leading us off in the second frame is Isaac Elliott. He started with a strike. Let's see if he can keep it going.
He certainly threw a very solid shot in the first frame.
That's right. He's taking his time. Oh, a bit tight. Ooh, and that's out the 10 pin.
Yeah, it looks like he might have stuck on that one just a little bit, caused him to pull the ball across his body. First frame, which is worth $20, jackpotted, so this frame is now worth $40.
Must make the spare. And does.
Yes, good solid spare. So Isaac's got the score on the board now, and everyone else has got to try and beat it.
You never know, nine spare might win it. Quite possible.
It's been known to happen. Ashley's certainly the power player of this group.
Yes, you'll be looking to make a few inroads, win a few skins early on.
Very, very deliberate. Back in his younger days, he was a bit of a tear away, but a lot more deliberate now.
That's right.
Sort of learned to harness the power a little bit.
He's still got a big backswing, but used to be a lot higher than that.
Look at that. That's just dead flush. Great shot there from Ashley.
With all those revs, the pins don't stand a chance.
That's right. And look at this. Ball goes in there. Clean. 10 disappear off the deck. Beautiful to watch. Now the pressure's on for either Danielle or Gordon to generate the two tie all tie situation.
Let's see if Danielle goes Brooklyn like in the qualifying.
He might happen too.
Oh, rookie.
All right, Nostradamus, explain that one to us.
Well, go for the left-hander's pocket, I reckon, Brenton. They seem to get all the strikes there.
See the ball basically deflecting down the picket fence there, actually giving a little bit of a jib there to Danielle for that forceful strike. But we had the two-tie, all-tie again. So
no
the money jacks.
Gordon.
That's right. No pressure. He just wants to get out, make a good shot, better shot than he made in the first frame.
That's right.
It's a nice situation to be in. Nicely balanced at the line. A little bit better shot, but he's still just a hair tight. Needs to give the ball just a little bit more room.
He's really trying to stuff the ball into the pocket rather than just letting the ball flow.
That's a good observation, Zach. He just looks like he's being a bit careful, trying to like place the ball on the target rather than just swing through the line. He'd go back, get himself lined up for the spare.
And does.
Spared very nicely there by Gordon. So we had the two tie, all tie again.
After two frames of the 10-pin shootout, we've had two ties. The skins have jackpotted. We're off the third frame action. Ashley Warren will lead off. Danielle Elliott will be second. Gordon Cole will be third. And Isaac Elliott will be in the anchor position. Let's go to the action.
All right, back to the third frame. Ashley's leading off, coming off a very nice strike. Let's see what he can do.
Looks very well lined up at the moment. He's really in a position here to put some pressure on the other guys.
He is. And, oh!
Little too much angle of entry here.
That's right.
A bit of a balance at the line.
Watch the ball miss the nine pin.
Yeah, just a little bit too deep in the angle of entry.
That's right.
Went straight past the nine.
Using a different ball for the spare and makes it.
One thing, Ashley's improved his spare shooting greatly over the last couple of years.
It's very important to make your spares.
Absolutely it is. I reckon you strike for show and spare for dough.
Yep.
Might not be the case in this, but... Oh, nearly got it again.
She seems to be going Brooklyn a lot, and it's paying off for her most of the time.
Most of the time it is. Looks like they're just not quite enough knee bend, and just dropped the shoulder a little bit, and that caused the ball to go way inside the target.
Now she spares this. We've got two bowlers on a nine spare.
Wow. Ooh. And with the nine spare, Ashley's still in the lead.
Two bowlers to come.
Will we get a win on a nine spare?
You never know.
Entirely possible looking at this.
Gordon just taking his time here. He knows he just needs to make a good shot. Very deliberate with his approach.
Extremely deliberate. He's a very experienced player. Hasn't been on TV a lot, but a couple of times in the South Australian Rockaway team, he knows how to bowl under pressure.
And that's much better.
Knew that shot was worth some money.
Oh, he did. Now, the pressure is on Isaac. Can he deliver?
Needs to deliver, otherwise Gordon's won himself $60.
That's right. Isaac got a strike on this lane in the first frame. Let's see if he can do it again. Looks pretty good. And he gets it.
What a great shot under the gun there from Isaac.
I bet Ashley and Danielle are loving that shot.
Well, we had some great clutch bowling there in frame three from Gordon and Isaac. The Skinners jackpotted again. Going into the fourth frame action, Danielle will lead off this time. Gordon will be second. Isaac third, and Ashley Warren will bring up the anchor position. Let's go to the fourth frame action.
And Danielle is first up for the fourth frame. Let's see if she can start with a strike. This frame's worth $80, I believe.
See what happens here.
Ooh. Lost balance. Bert gets the strike.
Might be something in that. Every time that she's been balanced, she's had the big crossover Brooklyn hit. But look at this.
Drops the shoulder and pushes the ball out.
You notice the slide foot went off about a 45 degree angle there. And that was what caused the loss of balance. But managed to hit her target and got the strike. So now she's in the position where she might win the skin.
Gordon, another aggressive shot.
Oh, great shot. He's lined up now, isn't he?
He certainly is. He's relaxed, just making his good shots.
Look at that. Dead flush. And this isn't the easiest pattern in the world either. It's the same pattern as was put down for the South Australian Cup earlier this year at Crossroad. Ooh. Oh, they're all lined up now.
I think they're going for the all-tie. Forget about the two-tie.
Certainly looks that way. But even when you, as we've said before, when you've got the two tight, you still need to go out, throw good shots, keep yourself lined up.
Keep your confidence up.
Exactly.
Now, Ashley, are we looking to get a strike as well? He's coming back and gets it.
Ashley's well and truly lined up. He's certainly bowling the best of the four at the moment. He started with two pocket strikes, a cold nine pin, and another pocket strike.
So he looks lined up.
He certainly does.
In the fourth frame, we had four strikes from the competitors. Therefore, the skin jackpots once again. The money's getting higher now. Let's see the action in the fifth frame.
Alright, now we're up to the fifth frame. Gordon's first up, and this frame is now worth $150 due to frames 1 to 4 jackpotting.
Now Gordon's thrown a couple of really good clutch shots in the last couple of frames. Let's see if he can do it again and put some pressure on.
Ooh, just a bit too tight there.
A little bit anxious, I think. Like he was just trying to stuff it right in there. Really put the pressure on everyone else.
Seems to be bowling very straight, so you haven't got as much margin for error.
Yes, you certainly... Gordon's not a player who likes to hook the ball. He prefers to play straighter angles, prefers to play the percentage. He's a bit more of an old-school style player.
And let's hope he goes and makes the spare. And he does.
Yeah, it's a good solid spare, that one. So Gordon, although it's only an 8 spare, he at least has the score on the board.
That's right. Everyone's got to chase it.
That's right. Isaac now up for his fifth frame.
Been looking for at least a 9 spare.
Anything better than 8 spare will put him in the box seat to win the skin.
Ooh, oh, wide. Ooh.
As we tend to say in the bowling game, that was out the window.
I guess it was.
Threw that one right out the window.
Had no chance of coming back.
He was around that one early. And you look at the bottom of the swing, the elbow was a bit bent. It's what we call a chicken wing. And when you do that, normally you miss way outside your target. Trying to make the spare.
He doesn't. It's all right. Now the pressure's on Ashley and Danielle. Can they deliver?
You wouldn't think beating an 8 spare would be that hard.
That's right. For these bowlers,
you know, when there's a bit of money up.
That's right.
Ashley's been very, very well lined up thus far.
Concentrating on his target. Coming back.
Ooh. Wow. Now, this gets very interesting.
It does.
The spare is not so much...
spare won't
the
win
factor
it.
Here, because the spare won't win it.
Danielle.
Now, Danielle has to get up and try and throw, at the very least, an 8 spare.
That's right.
To tie the skin.
Don't think Gordon will be believing what he's seeing. You would have never thought he'd win on an 8 spare.
You wouldn't have thought so, but it's a funny game. And a little bit of pressure can do strange things to you.
So is Danielle going to go brookie?
It's looking for the Brooklyn.
Oh. And you know what this means, Brenton.
Gordon's won the skin on an 8 spare.
$150.
How about that? Gordon would be sitting there half in a state of shock, I would imagine, because that's just...
unheard of, basically.
Well, that's right. Winning a skin on an 8 spare just generally doesn't happen. But it's an amazing game, skins bowling. Anything can happen.
And makes a spare, but doesn't change the outcome. Gordon still wins.
After five frames on the 10-pin bowling show shootout, we have our first skins winner, Gordon Colmer, with an 8 spare of all things, has collected our first skin. Gordon, how are you finding it out there?
Shot's holding pretty well for me. I got lucky with the 8 spare. The other four bowlers are top bowlers. It's not very often they'll miss a 9, so I got very lucky there.
Well, Gordon, you're our first winner. Congratulations. Let's go on to the sixth frame action now, where the order will be Isaac Elliott, Ashley Warren, Danielle Elliott, and Gordon Colmer.
Back to the sixth frame, after Gordon winning $150 for the fifth frame. Let's see what Isaac can do. Ooh, he's going for Danielle's line, the Brooklyn, but leaves a 10-pin.
Must be the Elliott family trait.
That must be.
Because there's not a lot of margin for error, it's like they're just trying to be a little bit careful with it, and especially when there's a bit of money on the line.
That's right.
You need to be able to freewheel through your target, and just at the moment, they're not quite doing that.
Must spare situation for Isaac.
That's right. Looking for the 10-pin, and missed it. I think he well and truly knows that he's out of contention for this skin.
Using his reactive ball for the spare there.
He generally prefers to try and flatten the reactive ball out, but doesn't always work, and on this particular occasion it certainly didn't, and it hooked away from the 10-pin.
I'd prefer a straight ball in pressure situations.
Oh, I agree entirely. It's Ashley now. Yeah, maybe sees a little bit of an opening here.
He should. Needs a good strike here.
Wow!
Look at that power, the messenger.
Have a look at that head pin come screaming back across the deck.
I think he liked that shot.
Let's have a look at it. Head pin to the wall, cartwheels back across the deck.
I feel sorry for that 10-pin.
Absolutely poleaxed. That's an intimidating shot in anyone's language.
That is.
Now, see if Danielle can get up and throw a good shot here.
Been looking to improve on her 6 spare?
Absolutely she would be. Is anything less than a strike's not up to
her? That's good. Oh.
Well and truly her best shot of the day. She's been Ashley's nemesis a couple of times now.
She has. You can see Ashley's not very impressed with that, but I'm sure you'll keep on target.
But at least this time he got beaten by a pocket strike.
That's
so
right.
It certainly made the difference. Pressure's off Gordon here now. He'd go out and just try and execute a good shot, get himself lined up. And even though the pressure's off, he's still not taking any less time than normal.
Oh, that's right. You want to keep in that rhythm.
That's right.
And
great
delivers.
Shot. That's a great shot there. Just important to get that pre-shot routine down.
Oh, that's right. I'm sure I'd be feeling a bit more relaxed after winning a skin.
Three strikes in the sixth frame means we have another tied skin. The jackpot's now into the seventh frame. The order will be Ashley Warren, Danielle Elliott, Gordon Colmer, and Isaac Elliott will be in the anchor position. Let's go to the seventh frame action.
First up, we have Ashley for the seventh frame. He's changed balls here. Let's see if it works. Well, I think he missed his target, but he's still got the strike.
It looks like he found a little bit of a hold spot with that ball. Went a lot longer. This getting now worth $125. Let's see what happens here. It looked like he missed that a little bit inside his target, but it held pocket.
That's right.
Destroyed the rack. And see if Danielle can be Ashley's nemesis once again. She's destroyed his winning chances a couple of times with some strikes. Let's see what happens here.
Bit wide, I reckon.
Nearly made up, but at least she's getting somewhere around the pocket now.
That's right.
Looks like she's settled down a little bit. The nerves have settled and starting to throw better shots. After with the two and the sleeper eight.
This can be a hard spare. I'm sure she'll make it. It doesn't change the outcome. Ashley's got the strike.
Yes, now for Danielle, it's about just maintaining her swing rhythm, getting lined up for any spare she might have to make later in the match.
Much better balance at the line there, but misses the spare.
Yeah, just missed a little bit inside her target. Probably hooked a little bit more in there than she expected it to. Normally when you shoot through the middle lane like that, the ball will hold its line, but this is a flatter pattern than the normal house pattern, so you miss inside your target, the ball will hook away.
Now Gordon, can he strike? Taking his time.
He's made some good shots in the clutch thus far.
Oh, he's going Brookie. Oh, what must Ashley be thinking?
That's the second time he's had his skin taken from his grasp by a Brooklyn strike. He just raised up on that one a little bit. Missed inside the target. Flush Brooklyn hit. Ashley must start be certain thing he's being ganged up on.
He must.
Have a look at him there. He's got that look of a little bit of resignation on his face, I think.
See if Isaac can strike. Ooh, ringing 10.
Ringing 10. Usually that's occurred when you're just a little bit fast with the ball. Speed ball just goes through the break point just a little bit. Ringing 10. Had plenty on it.
Yeah. Let's see if he can make the 10 pin this time. He missed it last time.
He needs to go back and make it just in case he has to later.
After the seventh frame, we've had another two-tie, all-tie situation. Therefore, next week in the eighth frame, we'll be playing for $250. And then we'll have the final two frames after that on next week's 10-pin bowling show shootout.
Some very interesting bowling there, Zach. Gordon Colmer winning $150 in the fifth frame with an eight spare, of all things.
I don't think you'll believe he actually won it on an eight spare.
I don't think he could either. We'll see more exciting action next week on the 10-pin bowling show shootout. Good night, Zach.
Good night.